is Susan Briley for CSO Online. Well, here we are. At the date I'm recording this, we have 1 day, 5 hours, 54 minutes, and 44 seconds and counting of a lifespan left for the end of Windows 7, and also Server 2008 R2 and Server 2008 SP2. But that doesn't mean we're not going to still be using it. So, this is just a reminder that you need to take action to either make sure that you have extended security updates or isolate it and get it off the web. Back in May, I talked about some of the ideas I had for isolating that environment. Virtualizing it, blocking it, install mitigation toolkit, put it on VLANs, disable autorun, review data execution prevention policies, make sure you update to the latest Office version, but you can also buy extended patches for it. Before you install these ESU keys, there's a couple of prerequisites. First off, you have to have KB490628 or later. This is a servicing stack update as of March 12, 2019. You can have later ones. This is the absolute minimum. You have to have the SHA-2 code signing patch, KB447-4419. For Server 2008 SB2, you also have to have a servicing stack update, KB449-3730. And also the SHA-2 co-signing patch, KB447-4419. Then you also have to make sure that certain patches are installed. For Windows 7, you need KB451-6655, a servicing stack update as of September 10th, 2019. Again, you could have a later servicing stack update, but this has to be the minimum. And then you have to have at least the October 8th, 2019, KB451-9976, the October monthly roll-up update. You can have the November, you can have a December, you could even have the January roll-up coming up, but you have to have this October update or later. For Server 2008 Service Pack 2, again, a September servicing pack stack update, KB451-7134, and then also the October 8th monthly roll-up of KB452-0002. And remember, if you have Windows 7 and you are Windows E5 or Microsoft 365 E5 customers, your Windows 7 licenses are included and you want to look in your Volume Licensing Center for those keys. You can also deploy this using SCCM and you don't have to do this one at a time. But I'm going to show you the process of what it's like on a single machine. You open up a elevated command prompt. You've received your product key from another location, either from your vendor, from your VLSC site, and you want to type in SL Manager IPK and then the product key. Wait a little bit and a screen will pop up and it will indicate that the product key has been installed properly. Now type in SL Manager / DLV. Again, be patient. And you'll see a activation screen come up. And this activation ID is the same for first year. You'll have a new one each year. So year 2 will be different, year 3 will be different. Now pop back to the command window. And that activation key that you see right there, you want to enter it in with the / ATO. Again, be patient. It'll indicate it was activated successfully. And finally, to confirm that it's done what you want it to do, the last time, type in SL Manager / DLV again. and it'll indicate that it's licensed for both the 1-year add-on as well as the base of the operating system. And there you have it. That's the process to add a single-year extension for Windows 7. So as we come to the end of life of Windows 7, don't forget to check out the technology headlines on Tech Talk from IDG. And remember, we have 3 more years, and Windows 2012 R2 will be out of support as well. So start those migration plans now. It'll come up on you faster than you think. Thanks again. This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online.